Shape selective catalysis. What is this? You know, this catalysis depends on the pore structure of catalyst and size of reactants and products. So a catalysis reaction which depends on the pore structure of catalyst and the size of the reactants and products is called shape selective catalysis. Here what happens is size of catalyst pores and the size of reactants are similar. That's why reactants, they simply enter into the pores of the catalyst. There they undergo reaction. And after the formation of products, those products come out of the pores. So this type of mechanism, this type of process is called shape selective catalysis. You know, zeolites act as shape selective catalysts. Zeolites act as a shape selective catalyst. Do you know the formula of zeolites? Zeolites formula is M is a metal, MX or N, AlO2 some X, SiO2 some Y, okay, MH2O. This is the general formula of zeolites. Zeolites may be naturally occurring or may be artificially made, that means man-made. Zeolites have natural existence and some zeolites are man-made. This is the general formula where N is the valency of metal M. Okay, similarly X and Y are number of these groups, number of AlO2 groups X, number of SiO2 groups Y. What is M? Where M is number of water molecules of crystallization. Number of water molecules. Number of water molecules of crystallization. Okay, so this is the formula of zeolites. You know, zeolites are microporous aluminosilicates with three-dimensional network. Zeolites, they have three-dimensional microporous structure. They have three-dimensional microporous structure with silicon, with aluminium, oxygen, silicon framework. This framework is present in zeolites. So some of silicon atoms in zeolites, what happens is some of silicon atoms are replaced by aluminium atoms. So zeolites have three-dimensional network. In that three-dimensional silicate network, some of the silicon atoms are replaced by aluminium atoms. That's why zeolites have aluminium, oxygen, silicon network. Aluminium, oxygen, silicon network. Okay. So here, catalysis reaction depends on the size of pore structure. That means it is zeolites are having honeycomb like structure. In honeycomb there are pores, na? Just like pores in honeycomb, zeolites as catalyst, it is also having pore structure. This pore structure and size of reactants and products, based on these pore structure and size of reactants and products, catalysis reaction occurs. So that's why it is named as a shape selective catalysis. If a shape of a pore structure and size of this similar, then only reaction takes place. Where are these zeolites used as catalysts? You know, these zeolites are used as catalysts. Zeolites are used as catalysts in petrochemical industry. Petrochemical industry for the cracking. Cracking means breaking of hydrocarbons. For the cracking and isomerization of alkanes. So in petrochemical industry, zeolites are generally used as catalysts. So there, in which process they are used? Cracking. Cracking means breaking of hydrocarbons by heating is called cracking. Similarly, isomerization means one isomer is converted into another isomer. Suppose if we take N-pentane, it is converted into either isopentane or neopentane. So such type of conversion of one isomer into another is called what? Isomerization. So cracking and isomerization, zeolites are used as catalysts. Among all the zeolites, ZSM5 is having importance. ZSM means zeolite Soconi Mobil. Zeolite Soconi Mobil. The company Soconi Mobil prepared this catalyst. This is the fifth zeolite prepared by that company. That's why it is named so, ZSM5. Okay, this is used as catalyst in the conversion of alcohols into gasoline. Alcohols into synthetic gasoline, that means synthetic petrol. You know, petrol is a mixture of hydrocarbons. So in the preparation of synthetic petrol from alcohol, it is used. So you know, here a dehydration takes place. This conversion takes place by dehydration. Dehydration means removal of water. So from alcohol, when oxygen is removed as water, then hydrocarbons are formed. So for that conversion, petrol is nothing but gasoline or synthetic petrol is a mixture of several hydrocarbons. Those hydrocarbons are obtained from alcohols by dehydration. So in that process, ZSM5 is used as catalyst. So this is about shape selective catalysis. What is that? Shape selective catalysis. Next, sixth one, enzyme catalysis. What are enzymes? Enzymes are complex organic compounds, nitrogenous organic compounds. Complex nitrogenous organic compounds produced in animals and plants. They are produced in living beings. These are complex compound, that means larger molecules. Nitrogenous compounds, that means organic compounds containing nitrogen. Complex nitrogenous organic compounds produced in our body or in plants. Okay, these enzymes are mostly, these are mostly proteins, and they form colloids in water. They form colloids in water. Enzymes, when dissolved in water, they form colloidal solutions. Later we have a topic there, I will discuss what is a colloidal solution. Okay? No, you know, enzymes are mostly proteins. Of course, there are some enzymes which do not contain protein part. Okay? Most of the enzymes, 99% enzymes are proteins. So, enzymes are not only, enzymes are naturally occurring, that means they are prepared in our body or in plants. You know, some enzymes are made artificially also. Enzymes are, can be crystallized. Enzymes can be crystallized from living cells. From the living cells, enzymes can be crystallized. Now, how do these enzymes act as catalysts? You know, these enzymes are also called biochemical catalysts, or simply biocatalysts. Why? In our body, different biological reactions occur. Those biological reactions or biochemical reactions are catalyzed by enzymes. That's why enzymes are called what? Biochemical catalysts are simply biocatalysts. Let's see some examples of where enzymes act as catalysts. In that, first one, in the inversion of cane sugar and in the conversion of starch into sucrose. In the conversion of starch into sucrose and in the conversion of glucose or fructose into, what is that, ethyl alcohol, different enzymes are used up. Let's see one by one. There is a table to show that the source enzyme and its working in some reaction. So let's see the table in which enzymes are acting as biocatalysts. So first one, enzyme. In second column, its source. Third column, the biological reaction or the reaction, the process in which the enzyme acts as catalyst. Let's see the three columns. First enzyme, invertase. Invertase, what is this? Its source is yeast. Yeast, it's a fungus. It is present in buttermilk, sour buttermilk. Okay, so it produces, yeast produces invertase. So this invertase converts sucrose into glucose and fructose. What is the formula for sucrose? C12H22O11. It is sucrose H2O gives rise to C6H12O6 plus C6H12O6. In this, one is glucose, other one is fructose. So in this process, invertase converts sucrose into glucose and fructose. It's a biological process. Second one, zymase. Its source also yeast. So in this, the glucose or fructose, C6H12O6, It may be glucose or fructose. It is converted into ethyl alcohol plus water. So for the conversion of ethyl alcohol, to CO2, for the conversion of ethyl alcohol into, how many oxygen here? 6 oxygen total. So water is not involved here. So glucose or fructose formed can be converted into ethyl alcohol and carbon dioxide. Okay, so in this process, what is the enzyme used up? Zymase. Third one. There is an enzyme diastase. You know, most of the enzymes, they end with ase, A-S-E, ase. Most of the carbohydrates, they end with ose, O-S-E, ose. Glucose, fructose, maltose, lactose, mannose, in that way. Carbohydrates mostly, they end with O's, whereas enzymes mostly end with A's, okay? Invertase, zymase, diastase, like that. So, source of this diastase is malt. Malt means sprouted barley. Sprouted barley. It means germinating barley. Okay, so it is the source of enzyme diastase. This diastase converts starch into maltose. What is the formula of starch? Formula of starch. So this starch on hydrolysis converts into maltose. Maltose and sucrose are having similar formula. Molecular formula is same for both, sucrose, maltose. C12H22O11. Okay, so in this process, conversion of starch into maltose, there diastase is used as an enzyme. Similarly, fourth one, maltase. For source of this maltase is yeast. What is the source for this maltase? Yeast. So here maltase converts maltose into, maltose means similar, C12H22O11, this is maltose. Like glucose, it is sucrose, it is having the same formula, plus H2O. Here 2 moles of glucose will be formed. This is glucose. Okay, right. So maltase converts maltose into glucose. Fifth one, urease. For this, soya bean is the source. Soya bean. It decomposes urea into ammonia and carbon dioxide. What is the formula of urea? NH2CO NH2. This is the formula of urea. NH2CO NH2. Now this urea is decomposed to ammonia plus CO2. Ammonia plus CO2. This decomposition is done by, in the presence of urease. Got it? Sixth one, lactobacilli. This is present in curd. It converts milk into curd. So for the conversion of milk into curd, the enzyme lactobacilli is used up. Similarly, there is an enzyme, pepsin. Its source is stomach. Its source is stomach. So here, this pepsin enzyme converts proteins into polypeptides. So when some bonds of proteins, you know, proteins in proteins, different amino acids are held by peptide bonds. If some of the peptide bonds are broken, they give polypeptides. If all the peptide bonds in a protein are broken, then they give amino acids. There is another enzyme, trypsin. Trypsin. So it is also present in stomach, but intestines. It is present in, it is pancreatic enzyme. It is present in intestines. It converts proteins into amino acids. So based on this table, you may have different questions. Reaction will be given. Enzyme you have to identify. Suppose decomposition of urea. Options, urease, gymase, lactate, zymase, invertase. In that way, options will be given. Which option you have to select? Urease. Because urease catalyzes the decomposition of urea into ammonia and CO2. Similarly, diastase. This diastase enzyme catalyzes the hydrolysis reaction of starch into maltose. Okay, so in that way you will have some objective questions directly from this table. So about 8 enzymes I had given. What are those 8 enzymes? Invertase, zymase, diastase, maltase, urease, lactobacilli, pepsin and trypsin. Their sources and their process in which they act as catalyst, you have to remember. Okay, so this is about enzyme catalysis. Next, let's see the characteristic properties of enzymes.